Starting our broadcast with my screen here. So we're going to start with Pure Synth Platinum. This is my go-to app right now. It's made by a gospel musician. Here's my user presets. You can make up your own, take a sound, add it, change it. Here's like four different sounds I've got on here with different effects and stuff on them. And you can see at the top left, there's this little power button on and off. You got 1, 2, 3, 4 next to it. Each module has that. So you can turn on that module and then change the settings for each sound. But here's what my sound sounds like. Got a little pad into it. Sounds pretty good. Pretty cool, huh? So again, it's got lots of built-in sounds to it. And so like the top one is kind of like built-in sounds, but you got all of these. I mean, it's got some good stuff. So like a cello here. And so I can go over here, there's nothing really with it. So I can add like, you know, I can go to like strings and pads, something like this. I can turn it on here. And you can have different controls. Pretty cool. But this is the main one I have. It's like 20, 30 bucks. But it's got all kinds of different stuff in this. And you can buy some of these other stuff in here. Like I haven't bought the suitcase expansion or the Pure Synth upright expansion, which I might look into doing that. But I do have, like, you know, stuff like this. This has got some really good stuff, especially the leads. So, very cool. Again, and you can do four layers. So it's like, it makes this worth it just for that. And I go back to my presets here. So like I have, you know, Sunday 3. More on the pad, and then Sunday 2. It's got an organ mixed in. So it's not bad. So that's the first app and the one I use the most. Let's see, hold on. Then I'm going to go over here and I'm going to show you Korg. So I've bought the Ivory plugin and it sounds really good. But a lot of times I'm using this for the pad too. But that's the Korg. Of course, I have it where you can also layer sounds in here. So, so sounds are layered. You can do more stuff than that, but that's kind of the Korg. And then Ravenscroft. This is a great, just grand piano-like sound. So just stock it. And I'll take the reverb off, turn the velocity down a little bit. Turn the timer down. another one I use some is MKSensation, especially if it's on my phone, because this one's phone. Pure Synth is only iPad. So I'll use this one on my phone. And right now you can see the lid up. I have a pad, EP2 and Power Grand. And I can go to acoustic piano sound. Throw out piano 2. You can do like Power Grand by itself. But then I can do this dynamo sound, which is kind of. So it's pretty cool. Pretty versatile, and again, it works on the phone. So the big app that I use is Camelot. It's like a main stage app, and it's kind of newer. There's not a lot of stuff on it on YouTube and stuff. It's still getting its foot in. You know, I bought it. You know, I pre-ordered it before it even came out because I was like, I want a main stage equivalent, and it does a lot what main stage already does now. You can add songs and songs. You can build scenes, and these scenes are basically patches, and you can put in multiple apps in that patch. So, for instance, this is what I call Keys of Pad. I can go to the layer, and I've got Pure Synth Platinum, which you can like open the module inside, and I've got Sundays 3. I got Ravenscroft here. And then I've got the Korg Module warm pad, so I'm mixing three different apps. Sounds pretty good. Sounds really good. And of course, I can mix it on the right side here. Mute them. You can even select what key ranges does, but you can add tracks here. But you know, it's seamless too. So keys, I'm gonna go to piano strings, piano and cello. So I have the cello. Now another thing is this, if I go look at key ranges, you'll notice the cello is only in the bottom part. So I hit up here. It's not, you can see it showing up here. It's not in there, which I don't want the high cello. So I can play the high chords. And then just the cello and the bass. So. Pretty cool. And the apps, not all apps work with it yet, but Pure Synth Platinum, this is this one right here is BS-16i. It's like a rudimentary thing that uses sound like old sound fonts and stuff like that, files. So I just got a cello on there. You can do Ravenscroft, Pure Synth Platinum works on here, BS-69, and Korg all work on here so far. So, but you can even map keyboards. So like, I'll go over here and show you, like we'll do a new one from scratch, and we'll do keyboard, even though I don't really have one that I'm mapping, but, and I can come over here and say, I'll edit it. let me delete that. Done. But I can come over here and I can say, from scratch, man, my bad. Piano. And then here's where I can go and do, here, it's this one, plus. So I create a new layer called piano plus, and I can do instruments and I can do hardware. So I'm not doing a VST or anything like that. I can do, like, it has Nord on here. Like, it actually has, like, all of these different keyboards. And they're constantly adding more. Even the IK, you know, multi stuff. So that you can you can tap into the sounds. So Kronos, like, you can click it and control the sounds with this so that you can make... you can make layers of it. So like for instance, if I had a Mod X, which is what we're getting at our church, I can select that and select patches from that and put it in here and just use this to control it. Let's see, motif, like they have a good amount of keyboards in here that are, you know, the main brands, Nord, Roland, you see on here. They even have Novations. Like, it's pretty sick. And you can add all that. And then you can go back and do software. And so here's, like, the software that I have that actually works with it. It has audio units. So you have to make sure if you buy something that it works with it. But it's pretty cool. You can insert effects, you can do layers, connectors, you can get kind of crazy with it. But anyways, those are the apps that I mainly use, and I hope this helps everyone.